Hi, in this video you're going to be learning how to make a basic goat cheese. So in my last video we showed how to milk a goat and we asked if anyone wanted to see what we do with the goat milk after we get it. One of the things we do is make goat cheese. To make this, you're going to need a few tools. This is a hanging station, the wood part, and if you don't have that, when you're ready, you can just hang it on your kitchen faucet and just let it hang until there's no more drips. This is a cheese press and it just helps the cheese stick together while it's setting. It's not exactly necessary, but we're gonna play with this later. You're going to need a pot, and then we lined a colander with three layers of cheesecloth, and so while we're using the cheesecloth so that it doesn't move on us, we have a hairband holding it in place. We have a thermometer because we're going to need to be able to see when it's at 180 degrees. And for the recipe, we're going to need 8 cups or 2 quarts of milk, 2/3 of a cup of lemon juice, 2 tablespoons of white vinegar, and 4 teaspoons of cheese salt. This is 2 teaspoons of cheese salt. Now, this is a doubled recipe, so if you want to do just half of that, that's fine. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna take our milk and we're gonna heat it until it reaches 180 degrees. However, you can't let it heat too fast. We personally like to heat ours at about 5 or 6 on an electric stove, which is just medium heat on a normal stovetop. If you do it too fast, it's going to curdle. Now, we want it to curdle to make cheese, but this is a different type of curdle. Trust me, we've made this mistake. So we're just gonna pour it in our pot and then we're gonna heat it. Sorry, I spilled a little bit. I had to clean it up. So now that we've poured it in, we only want this on medium heat, so again, it doesn't curdle. I have my thermometer here, and I'm just gonna wait for this to get to 180 degrees Fahrenheit. So we've reached 180 now, so now we're gonna remove it from the heat. Lemon juice, and we're going to stir it a couple times until it's combined. See it curdling? Now we're going to add our vinegar, add this too. And then we're going to stir and let it sit for about a half hour. So it's been 30 minutes, and now what we're going to do is we're going to take the milk and put it in the cheesecloth. The curds here are not very big, and this is what we're looking for. This is the reason we need the cheesecloth, because they're very small. So we're gonna let the whey, which is the liquid that's not curdled, we're gonna let that drip out and then we're gonna add the salt. So it's not draining as well, so now that we have it poured in, we don't really need the hairband anymore, so we're just gonna go ahead and take it off. So now I'm gonna gather the 4 corners of the cheesecloth. You're going to want to be careful not to touch this one. It's very hot. So this is why we're going to put it on our hanging rack, so that this can drain out. Because this is going to take forever. If you don't have a hanging rack, again, you can just use the kitchen faucet and just let it hang there. Okay, so to get it on here, I'm going to use my hairband again. I have it in half, and I'm just going to tie it. Tight. I'm gonna move it over here. I'm gonna separate it into two ends so I can tie it onto the hanging rack. While I'm tying this, what can we do with the whey? We found out that a lot of people like to use it as water in some recipes. We can wash greens in it. Okay, so we've been letting this strain for about an hour or so, and I'm really happy with the amount of whey that came out. I already switched the plates. And now what I'm gonna do is add the chicks salt. So I'm gonna untie this. And some people stop it just here. They just roll it into a tube while it's in the cheesecloth, and then they take it out, put it in a Ziploc, and refrigerate it. But we're gonna try to press it, because we like to be able to cut. You wanna make sure that, oops. You want to make sure that each part of your cheese gets some salt. Otherwise, areas are going to be too salty, and then other areas are going to be really bland. Now we're going to fold it back up and put it in our cheese press. If I find it again, I'm going to put a link on our description for it. So now I'm going to wrap this back up a little tighter so that it fits inside our press, and then we're going to press it down. We're gonna push this down and it's gonna start pressing. As you can see, there's more whey coming out. Depending on how dry you want your cheese, the harder you're gonna press. If you want a rather wet cheese, it's gonna be really hard to slice. Then you don't want to press as much. Okay, so this looks like it's good enough for now. We're gonna let it sit for about another hour and then we'll check on it. Okay, so this has been pressing for a couple of hours and there's no more dripping or anything happening, so we're gonna open it up and see how it looks. That's our basic goat cheese. When you're done, you're just gonna wrap this in saran wrap or plastic wrap or something and refrigerate it.
This is just a basic cheese recipe. Don't forget that you can make different kinds of cheeses by altering your recipe. The most common recipes for goat cheese are feta and chèvre, which is a French goat cheese. Did you make this recipe? Let us know in the comments how it turned out. Did you want me to see me make a different variety of cheese? Feel free to leave a comment on which variety you'd like. Thank you!